So a little while ago, I embarked on a health and nutrition program with Zoe. But the big question is, did Zoe change my life? I'm Dr. D. I am 62 years old and I'm working on my 40-year plan. Part of that is to make sure that I can eat as healthily as possible.
Real treat.
I'm on a journey to understand how different food affects my body. I have embarked on a testing regime run by Zoe Science and Nutrition. This has included putting on a continuous blood glucose monitor, doing some tests with some controlled meals, collecting a poo sample and sending that off for analysis, and doing a blood test. Zoe took my results and gave me scores for my control over blood sugar, which is good control at 64 compared to the general population between 29 and 52. When it came to blood fat control, the picture wasn't so rosy. I got a poor score at 46. Compared to the general population of similar age and sex of 22 to 49. The exciting bit was, what was my poo sample going to tell me? Well, it turns out I've got quite a few good bugs and not so many bad bugs. My Zoe microbiome health score came in at a magnificent 85. Excellent, according to Zoe. Very pleased about that because I eat lots of fermented foods, lots of vegetables, blah blah blah, and I hope to be doing a video soon about making your own fermented foods. So now is the ideal time to like and subscribe. A central feature of the Zoe program is their app, which you can download onto your smart devices. Through this, you can track your foods. Once Zoe have compiled your test scores, they can then assign a score to any type of food that you eat. You can then build individual foods into recipes and meals. As you go through your day, you can score your breakfast, your lunch, your dinner, etc. Not forgetting to add in any snacks or drinks other than water. The app compiles all of that information into a daily score and a weekly score. At the same time, they give you little lessons through the app to help you decide which foods are better for you. This gives you the opportunity to swap out foods that are not so good for you and swap in some good foods. For example, I swapped out having oats as my breakfast cereal and brought in having nuts and seeds with fruit and kefir. This is a long-term beneficial change I've been able to make with my diet. Over the 3 to 4 months that I've been using the app, I've got to understand a bit about the sorts of foods that are good for me and give me a high score and how to combine them into meals so that I can be eating more healthily. About 2 years ago, I had a bit of a health scare. My blood pressure was doing some funny things and giving some very high readings. I was feeling a little bit stressed, I suppose, which is why I went to the doctor in the first place. My cholesterol was a bit high, and whilst I wasn't very overweight, I was getting heavier than was good for me. I was threatened with statins and thought, I'm not having any of that. So I've got to take myself in hand and change my lifestyle, my exercise, and my eating. Therefore, I decided to take myself in hand. I started doing a bit more exercise. And I've got plenty of other videos that you can look at to see some of my exercise regimes that I've been following. And also, I thought I need to reform my diet so it's healthy. The first thing I did was cut out some of the high glycemic index foods, supermarket bread, pasta, potatoes, because the starch and the carbohydrates in those foods pretty much turns straight to sugar when you eat it, enters your bloodstream, and if you're not burning that sugar off, it gets converted to fat. But then I came across Zoe. Therefore, I decided to enroll upon the Zoe Science and Nutrition Testing Program and see my other videos, which walks through the story of how I did the tests and what my results were. So when I got my results, it was clear I would have to make some further changes to my diet. Out went my usual breakfast, which was oats with some nuts and some kefir. And I was swapping out the oats for just nuts and fruit. That gave me an improved score for breakfast. I also discovered how bad some foods that appear healthy, when you look at the label, are not healthy. Here's a great example, some sourdough bread from Tesco. It looks like it should be very healthy, but when I do a scan, I discover it only gets a score of 43. Enjoy in moderation, which means maybe once or twice a week. Fortunately, I'd cut bread out anyway, but that was more by luck than design. One of the changes that we've definitely made to our diet is we have a lot more beans and pulses, legumes. Things like red kidney beans. These get a fantastic score of 93. Because we wanted to make our lives a bit easier when cooking these beans and pulses, you can get them in tins and that's fine, but it's cheaper if you can buy them dried and cook them yourself. But they take a long time cooking. We invested in a pressure cooker. That has been a positive revolution. I have also become better at listening to my body's hunger cues, spacing my meals out. And if I get a bit peckish, don't be fearful of having a snack. And nuts are brilliant and tasty. Now, Zoe wants you to log everything, and that can be a little bit of a pain. The app is very good. As you've seen, you can scan barcodes and put your meals together. But if you don't have barcodes and you're cooking from scratch, which we do a lot because we eat a lot of vegetables, you have to enter those in by hand. A great feature of the app, though, is that if you've got a recipe, you can take a photograph of it, and using their AI algorithm, they will compile the menu for you. And that comes with the score. So, although it's good to do, it gets a bit tiresome. And I must admit, there are many days where I haven't logged at all. And that is one of the reasons why, when my subscription comes up in a few days' time, I'm going to desubscribe from Zoe. Not because it's not good, but because I think I've learnt enough to make good choices without the need to constantly be referring to the app, which when I'm busy, I don't do anyway. So, has Zoe changed my life? And before I tell you that, you must like and subscribe. In truth, I started my changing diet about 18 months, 2 years ago. And I think I'd probably made changes that Zoe or the Zoe app would have prompted me to make anyway. I think in some ways I was probably doing reasonably well, therefore the room for improvement wasn't as great as it might have been had I started with the app about 2 years ago. But without a doubt, the structured approach in the Zoe app would have saved me hours of listening to random podcasts and reading loads of books. So if you want a time-efficient way to improve your diet, Zoe's a good way to go. Therefore, Zoe has crystallized what I was beginning to do anyway. It's guided me in the right direction and provides all the scientific backup, which I consider very important. It's so easy to go and listen to supposed influencers who, rather than talking from a position of knowledge, are talking out their backsides. getting our general day-to-day diet right is a complicated process. The app does seek to make it as straightforward as possible, but you do need to be diligent and paying attention to logging carefully and regularly until you begin to get to know what are the good choices, what are the less good choices, so you can compile your diet in the most healthy way without having to constantly refer back to what an app is telling you. I now feel ready to stop the Zoe program. Has it changed my life? In little ways, yes, but I think I was on the journey already. But don't let that stop you. If you're interested, go and check them out, and I would thoroughly recommend the Zoe Science and Nutrition program. Anyway, that's it for now. Catch me in the next video. Goodness knows what it'll be, but I'm sure it'll be fun.